कैत डाले कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय धर भक्ताय नमो नमः By the causes must have seen Guru and Gauranga. As we perform our Navridham Parakrama through the island of Godrum, now we have come to this supremely pure holy place, Suvarna Vihar. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his Navridham Mahatmya describes the first parikrama of Navadvipa, where Sri Nityananda Prabhu is leading Srila Jiva Goswami and revealing the Dharma to him. So, as they were performing kirtan, Nityananda Prabhu and Srivas Thakur and other associates of Mahaprabhu, they came here. Sri Nityananda Prabhu said, O Jiva, you should know that this place is called Suvarna
Vihara.
Because millions of years before in the Satyuga,
there lived
a king named Suvarna Sen.
Suvarna
Sen was always engaged in various rituals of Karmakanda, fruitive activities. And his life was going by even when he was old. He never gave up his enthusiasm for trying to do some pious activities. Because the people who know about the Purusharthas, the various goals of life, they know that Dharma leads to Artha. If you want to become wealthy, have a lot of money, be pious and religious, and that will be the result. Who knows what he may have performed in his previous life to have the association one day of Narad Muni. Narad Muni is so completely swatantra, he can wander anywhere and give mercy to anyone, even those without piety. So when Narad Muni arrived in his palace, then Suvarna Sen bowed down to him and did puja, worshipped him very elaborately. So then Narad Muni, he took Suvarna Sen to one side, to a private place. He said, now you are becoming old. And still your mind is only thinking money. You should know that material wealth, it cannot save you, it cannot help you. You should know that all those persons for whom you are collecting the wealth, also you have no eternal or real relationship with them. Very soon you will die. And your wife and your family members will put your body in the Ganges and go home, and everyone will forget about you. So there's no happiness in sense gratification and fruitive activities.
кармической деятельности.
So don't try for bhakti.
Поэтому не стремись к мукти.
In material enjoyment, and don't try to get mukti, also liberation.
Не стремись к чувственному наслаждению и не стремись к мукти, персональному освобождению.
There's no happiness in that also.
Это тоже не принесет тебе счастье.
Because when the triputi vinash, that means the seer and the seen and the instrument of seeing, when they are all destroyed, then there's no experience of subject and object. So in that state of liberation, there's no happiness at all.
Бхакти создает трипути винаш, когда исчезает разница между видящим объектом видения и инструментом видения. Ты не сможешь воспринимать объективность ничего в таком состоянии мукти.
It is like suicide.
Это подобно суициду.
It is a spiritual self-destruction.
Это духовное саморазрушение полное.
So don't look for mukti and don't look for mukti.
Поэтому не стремись ни к мукти, ни к бхакти.
Those who are on those paths, they are completely unaware of the true treasure of their heart.
Люди, которые идут этими путями, они совершенно ничего не понимают об истинном сокровище.
Every living being by nature is the eternal servant of Krishna.
Каждый человек, каждое живое существо по природе это слуга Кришны.
And true happiness lies in only pleasing Krishna. Then automatically the soul becomes overwhelmed with joy.
Истинное счастье кроется в возможности служить Господу, и тогда душа будет по-настоящему осознанной и счастливой.
So you should engage yourself in Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Vara Sevanam, Achanam, Bhangam, Dasam, Sakyam, Atmanivedanam. The nine angas of bhakti.
Немедленно начинай заниматься практикой бхакти, главными ангами бхакти.
Then Narad Muni said, actually, your great fortune is that you live here in this place.
И затем Нарада сказал, я хочу тебе поведать, что тебе невероятно повезло в том, что ты живешь на этом месте.
This is the eternal dharma of Gauranga.
Это вечная обитель Гауранги.
He will appear in the Kali Yuga.
Он придет на землю.
And spread love for Krishna through the chanting of the holy names.
И будет раздавать любовь к Кришне посредством воспевания святых имен.
But he is eternally present here, even though unmanifest. He said, Narad Muni said, if you worship Krishna, you can attain love for Krishna, but after a very, very long time. But if you worship Krishna in the form of Gaura Hari, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then because he does not accept any offenses, very quickly you attain prema.
Если ты будешь почитать Кришну в его облике Гауранги Махапрабху, Гаурахари, то так как он не принимает никаких оскорблений, очень быстро ты достигнешь совершенства в этом поклонении.
So as Narad Muni was remembering Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associates, he became overwhelmed in ecstasy. And he began to sing Gaura Hari Bol, Gaura Hari Bol. And his Veena, you know, his Veena is alive. So then his Veena also started singing Gaura Hari Bol,
Gaura.
And he doesn't play the Veena, he's too intoxicated with brain. He just sings and the Veena joins in.
Вина сама подыгрывает ему, потому что ему некогда играть на вине, он слишком поглощен киртаном.
And then Narada didn't know where he was and he just went dancing off into the forest of
Narada.
But his association made a very deep impression in the heart of the king. So that night, Suvarna said he went to sleep. And in his sleep, he saw Gauranga Dada and all the associates of Mahaprabhu doing kirtan. And the waves of prema were emanating from them. It was such an astonishing sight. And then suddenly Mahaprabhu disappeared. Then the king woke up. And now, having tasted the nectar of the sweetness of Mahaprabhu, he was feeling separation and crying, Ha go, ha go! Then he heard a voice in the sky, aerial voice, Akashvani. He said, You will appear along with my associates.
И этот голос провозгласил: ты придешь среди моих преданных.
And you will be Buddhimantakan.
Ты воплотишься среди моих преданных и станешь Буддимантаканом.
And then the king, he fainted in ecstasy. So Buddhimantakan, do you remember when we were in Chandrasekhar Bhavan, when Mahaprabhu wanted to do a drama, then he used to ask Buddhimantakan, you have to supply all the stage and the scenery and all the costumes and ornaments, because he was very wealthy.
Буддимантакан был очень состоятельным, а Махапрабху поручал ему закупать всю эту бутафорию для театра, все эти костюмы, когда он ставил театральные постановки.
And when it was announced that Nimai Pandit would be married to Vishnupriya,
когда все объявили о том, что будет свадьба между Нимай Пандитом и Вишнуприей,
Буддимантакан said, I will bear the entire expense for the wedding ceremony.
Буддимантакан сказал, я беру на себя все расходы.
And for hosting all the guests.
Я возьму на себя все расходы, связанные с этой свадьбой. Я буду кормить всех гостей, расселять всех гостей.
So Nimai Pandit used to teach. He's tall. His Sanskrit school was in the house of Sanjay Mukunda.
Школа Nimai Pandita, в которой он преподавал.
Sanjay Mukunda said.
Доме Sanjay Mukunda,
правда? Sanjay Mukunda said, but I will also bear a portion of the expenses.
Sanjay Mukunda вызвался тоже проспонсировать свадьбу, сказал, я тоже на себя беру часть расходов.
Buddhimantakan said, my dear
Sanjay,
this is not going to be like a little wedding of the poor brahmanas. This is going to be a ceremony and a celebration, all fit for a prince. So just leave it to me, I've got this covered. So that came by the mercy of Narad Muni. He became a very near and intimate, like family member of Chaitanya
Mahaprabhu.
So when Nityananda was explaining this to Jiva Goswami, then Shiva Thakur was there and he fainted in ecstasy. Because he was remembering that he's Narad. He was remembering how he had blessed that king. And when Jiva Goswami saw Shiva Thakur faint in ecstasy, Jiva Goswami also fainted in ecstasy. So then slowly Jiva Goswami came back to external consciousness. And the devotees and Nityananda began to do kirtan. And then Jiva Goswami looked and he saw Gaura Gadadhar and their associates dancing. And he danced along with them until midday. And then the spurti disappeared. So this is a real experience of parikrama. When the pure devotees do parikrama and hear the katar of the pastimes of Mahaprabhu, then by the influence of Prauda Maya, they also have the visions of that leela. Suvarnasen Maharaj ki jai, Narad Muni ki jai, Subhana Vihar ki jai, Buddhimantakan ki jai, Sri Nityananda Prabhu ki jai, Sri Jiva Goswami Pahad ki jai, Shiva Thakur ki jai, Gauramankar se Harinam Sankirtan ki jai, Shiva Dhudri Bhargava ki jai, Jai Gaur Premanande Hari.